Now let's see the Brahmaputra basin. River Brahmaputra originates in Tibet and is known as Tsangpo in Tibet. Okay, so this river Brahmaputra, where does it originates? It originates in Tibet. And what is it known by? Which name it is known in Tibet? It's known by Tsangpo River. Okay, in Tibet. So river Brahmaputra, it flows eastwards and parallel to the Himalayas, and then it enters in India in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. It flows through Assam before entering Bangladesh. So before it enters Bangladesh, it flows through Assam. So the Brahmaputra basin receives heavy rainfall. So sometimes the heavy rainfall floods the river and its surrounding. The alluvial soil brought down by the flooded river is very fertile, and crops like rice and jute are grown in plenty here. Okay, so this river brings along with it which soil? Alluvial soil, which is very fertile in growing crops. Satluj Basin. The Satluj Basin lies in the western part of the plains. Okay, so where does it lies? It lies in the western part of the plains. The major states covered by this basins are Punjab and Haryana. Okay, so Punjab and Haryana is in the west of India, isn't it? So these states are covered by Satluj Basin. Okay, the main tributary of river Satluj is River Bees. So which is the main tributary of river Satluj Basin? It's River Bees. Okay, the Satluj joins River Indus in Pakistan and drains in the Arabian Sea. Okay, this region does not receive much rainfall and is dry. Like the Brahmaputra Basin, this basin, the Satluj Basin, it does not receive much rainfall, and so it is dry. Because it is dry, dams and canals are built along River Satluj. You can see the picture of dam here. Okay, so as it is dry, what is built here? Dam is built across the Satluj. Okay, this dam provides water for irrigation and also electricity. Okay, so what does this dam provides? It provides irrigation as well as electricity. Fine. The Indira Gandhi Canal, which starts from Satluj, provides water to the dry land of Rajasthan. So the Indira Gandhi Canal, the name of the canal, that is Indira Gandhi, it starts from Satluj and it provides water to the dry land of which place? It's Rajasthan. Okay, the major crops of this region are wheat, rice, cotton and sugar cane. So what are the major crops of this region? It's wheat, rice, cotton and sugar cane. Okay, the important cities of this region include, which are the regions that it include? Chandigarh, Ludhiana, Patiala, Amritsar, Jalandhar and Ambala. Okay, now we will be looking at the importance of the northern plains. The fertile soil of the region is good for growing various crops. So the fertile soil of the northern plains, what is it good for? It is good for growing various kinds of crops. Okay, moderate climate has led to the settlement of people in large numbers around this region. So because of its moderate climate, a lot of people is settled in this region. Okay, many cities like Patna, Kolkata, Varanasi and Delhi have been built on the river banks. Okay, so the cities like Patna, Kolkata, Varanasi and Delhi have been built on these rivers. Okay, the flat land of this region has helped in the development of roadways and railways, and thus helping the transportation of the food produced to various parts of the country. So this is the importance of the northern plains. Okay, so here we have completed the chapter.